This is TWiT.
You have one, Dwight. I have an iPhone 11 Pro Flomax.
Yes. I've already taken cat pictures in the dark.
And?
Nice.
And?
And they look great.
All right.
They look great. It's nice. Really the video, the photo quality. So this is my cat. The room was actually pretty dark. And
whoa, aww. That looks perfectly brightly lit.
It does. It looks like a normal lighting. And it's really, and you know, this is mostly what I do with my camera is cat pictures in the dark. So I'm really excited.
If you put it on a tripod, you can get an astrophotography picture of your cat in the dark.
I've seen people doing that. I've seen sky photos already with those.
28 seconds.
Really? Using Focus or using the Apple app?
No, using the Apple app, but it'll only come on when it detects no movements. You've got to put it on a tripod, and then it'll let you pull the little dial all the way to 28.
Scooping Google a little bit on that one, because, of course, astrophotography is one of the things Google talked about in the sneakily released. Actually, this is an interesting question. There was a video, promo video of the Pixel 4, which isn't out yet. Google presumably announcing it October 15th. And there was a video that was, you know, leaked somehow. Somebody got it and showed it and showed astrophotography. And there is, I think some people think Google intentionally does these leaks. I'm sure
they do.
Do you?
They do. And particularly in this year, case, they actually have.
Well, this year they've admitted it. They said, well, because of all the leaks, we're going to show you the back of the phone.
Yeah, right.
But this one was, nobody took credit for this. This was a leaked. What is that you have?
Oh, I think.
That's the astrophotography.
Oh, so you did it.
You put it on the tripod, and then if you tap the little yellow icon, it gives you a dial, and you can pull it down to 0 to turn night mode off, normally up to 3 to go to full night mode, but if it's totally stable, you can pull it all the way to 28 and then just sit there while it slowly resolves all the stars in the sky, which is pretty neat.
There really is parity between Google and Apple at this point in terms of...
You know, we did a test. We took out the P30 Pro, the Samsung Galaxy Note 10, the Pixel 3, and the iPhone iPhone 11. And just to make sure it wasn't me, I brought Hayato Hausman of Android Central and Michael Fisher, who does Mr. Mobile, and we all three did it together. And the way I would sum it up is... So Huawei has magnificent hardware, absolutely stunning hardware with terrible color science and algorithms. And Google has mediocre camera hardware with the world's most spectacular algorithms. Samsung is just, I don't know, they're like trying their best. They turned my beard into plastic, which was very unusual.
They simultaneously oversharpen and oversaturate.
Yes.
And so it's like you get the worst.
It's like schmeary. Apple's got pretty good hardware and pretty good algorithms. Not as good hardware as Huawei, not as good algorithms as Google, but because they have both of them, like 100% photo pixels and really good light intake plus pretty good algorithms, they managed to compete with Google. And I think that's pretty interesting.
Honestly, for normal people, they'd be happy with any of those, really. I don't think they're going to. It's only if you compare them side by side that you even can see
the difference. If Dwight's cat looked plastic and bright green, he might not be so happy.
I have to say, I still think that the iPhone video is the best.
Everybody agrees on that.
I
think that's increasingly important. Like, even if you have amazing still photography, if you can't get a great video with the kind, like with the needs of the average person, they want to upload like videos to TikTok and stuff.
And the new image stabilization is pretty amazing.
I just thought of 60 frame per second interleaved extended dynamic range TikTok, Leo. That's where our culture is going.
What are you talking about?
The new iPhone camera shoots 120 frames per second, uses half of that for extended dynamic range, and makes a 60 frames per second 4K video, and it could be a TikTok meme. I'm just saying.
Here is from Reddit a post showing image stabilization. In the new, the far left, same thing. The guy's running along in a field. On the far left is the iPhone 11 Pro Max. The middle is the 10S Max. The right is the Note 10. And it's pretty clear that the image stabilization in the 11 is really good on the far left. That's the smoothest of the three. Now that's, you know.
They're trying hard to keep the color the same as you move through different lighting situations.
Yeah, actually, I wish he'd gone into shadow because that would have been an interesting test of it. Yeah. Nevertheless, that's impressive. I agree with you, Louise. I think especially, and it's not out yet, but they showed this on stage at the Apple event, when Filmic Pro comes out, which is a third-party app, it will apparently, this is a feature in iOS 13, it will be able to shoot video from two or more of the lenses. So you can have the front, the selfie cam on at the same time as you have the back camera on.
Oh,
and tape an interview and record both sides of the interview. And then in editing, you don't have to do a second, you know.
And your close-up and wide angle, and you can switch between them in the editing.
Do you know, Renee, yet? It's not out yet, but if that will use
I got to try it.
You did get to try it. Can it do more than two lenses?
So I got conflicting information on it. A couple people said it was limited to two, but the demo I did was shooting all four. So I don't know if that's what the real capability is, or if that was something they're experimenting with and are not sure they're going to launch. But the demo I did with it was four cameras.
So imagine that. I mean, I'm thinking of taking this to CES because then I could shoot a close-up, a wide angle.
Yep.
I mean, I could, and I could have my image on there. I mean, that's...
Your reaction shots, Leo. Leo reacts to his own CES
video.
That's
a testament to actually the speed of the processor, right? Yeah. And the speed of the storage that it can do.
Right, let's back up a little bit. What would you do with all four? Like, what would... So,
edit them. So here's the scenario, Louise.
You put them together later.
Yeah, I'm at CES. I get them all recording. And then when I edit it, I can have a wide angle of me standing there with a guy. I can have a picture of me asking him questions, close up of the product. I can have all of that. And then our editors pick and choose. It's like a four-camera shoot. Yeah. Of course, the camera's in the same position, so it's not as good as a four-camera shoot. But
it's still, I mean, that's a lot. I feel like the two or three makes sense, but the four is like
four
really
is more
like,
than you need.
Yeah, I think that's more than you need.
Yeah, four's over.
I can tell you in newsrooms, there's a lot of discussion about this particular camera and the use of it for journalism and being able, as you said, you know, to do interviews, to show events as they happen and have narration at the same time. A lot of photojournalists are really interested in this.
Well, and I'm sure all of you have done this. I certainly have. You know, when you're going out in the field to do reporting, very often there's you go with a camera crew, but there's only one camera and you're doing an interview. So you have to do the dumbest thing, which is you ask your subject question. The camera's pointed at the subject. You ask him a bunch of questions. He records his answers. Then you go, thank you very much. Goodbye. The camera goes and starts pointing at you. And now you have to pretend. You have to go, you have to pretend you're listening to the guy, which is totally phony. Because you can't, because you only have one camera, so you can't get that shot unless you do it twice.
Jeff Bridges movie? The Jeff Bridges movie that Network, it wasn't Network, it was him and Holly Hunter. They did the same, it was a trope on that.
It wasn't Jeff Bridges.
Yeah. Was it?
No, it was the other guy. you're talking about Broadcast News.
Oh, okay.
Broadcast News.
It wasn't
News,
Jeff Edwards. Jeff, it was, what's his name? It's the wooden guy.
Right, yes.
The guy made out of wood.
Yes.
Yeah, that actor.